Hi everyone, time for a new do-it-yourself acrylic fluid paint pour tutorial. In this demonstration I will show you how you can make these lovely small fridge magnets yourself, and I will guide you through the process how I did them. Of course you can see in the video what I actually do, but in the very beginning I of course, and you of course, will need these small canvases. And these are 5x5 cm, and it's more or less a canvas board. So it's basically cardboard wrapped with the linen canvases are made of, and you can buy these very cheap in your local art stores or online. As I do not have these in local art stores as cheap as I can get them online, I normally order them in quite large amounts. If you are from Germany, I myself order them from kreativ.de, which is quite cheap to get there. And once you have your little small tiny canvases, and actually you can use any size whatever you would like to use. I think the smallest out there are 4x4 cm here in Germany, and I wouldn't recommend going any smaller because it's going to get ridiculous if you go smaller. And it's even quite tricky and time intense making these in this size, so yeah, I think it's a nice size to go for. What you will also need is of course acrylic paint, as this is for acrylic pours. If you like, you can also use a medium to mix your acrylic paint into it. I myself used my rest amount of Floatrol, which did not last for the entire project, so I just used the last bits of it, and I also used some acrylic binder, which is basically just the medium the acrylic paint is made of. So acrylic binder plus the pigment makes the acrylic paint, so this is just the acrylic binder without any pigment, and this is just to extend my color a bit. You can also of course use just water, but having too much water used, the paint gets too thin and too runny and does not work in the end as pretty as you might have wanted to work. So yeah, you can use of course more paint and a bit of water to have the amount that you need, or just use the paint and some medium. And for me, for the medium, if you use Floatrol, it is 3/4 of the medium and 1/4 of the paint. This of course depends a bit how thick the paint is. If you have thicker acrylic paint, then you might need a bit of water as well. If your paint is just perfect in consistency, you might not need any water. But this is just your personal preference, so test out what works the best. So the first thing that I basically had to do is to unwrap all these tiny canvases, because they were all covered in clear film, which was a fun thing to do. Once I unwrapped all my 200 little canvases, I lined them up on my surface here, and I myself used a grill for this. So just some elevated surface that the paint that you pour onto it can drop down if it's too much paint, and you will need too much paint. So yeah, I lined them up because I always strive for efficiency. In the very first beginning, when I did my very first magnets, I made them one by one, which worked as well, but it was really, really time consuming. And you know, time is money, and you want to be as efficient as possible. So I lined them up this time and wanted to pour over them all at once and basically swipe over them. Just as a side note, when I mixed all my colors, I also added some drops of silicone into them, and I used dimethicone, which is just a skin-friendly silicone, for it. And as I want to have very small cells for these tiny pours, I stirred it very, very good. Because the better you stir your silicone into your color, the tinier the cells will become. If you just give it a gentle stir in the very beginning, you will end up having very large cells, which you might not want to have in such a tiny canvas. If you want to go for a larger canvas or project, of course you want to have bigger cells, probably, so don't stir as much as you need to stir here. So once I had all my canvases lined up and my colors mixed, I used a small cup to put some of the colors in to create a dirty pour. And once this was done, I just poured it over all these canvases. Of course, you will not be able to cover all the canvases all at once, and therefore I decided to go for a swipe. I used my large palette knife and I swiped all of them all at once. Of course, I wanted to have them all pretty and beautiful, but as of the number of these canvases and as it's quite unpredictable how the pour is going to end up, I was not sure if every little canvas will look pretty in the end. But lucky me, most of them really did. So I only had a handful that I sorted out in the end, which I will overpour for the next attempt. But I think about 95% from all of my canvases that I did were kind of pretty. And if you have any areas which look strange or not nice or just muddy, whatever can happen in these pores, just swipe over it again or add some color over it, some pure color, and swipe this color into the already poured color, and you will see if this changes something to the good. I had to do this every now and then, especially when I had some tricky color schemes like white, black and gold, because these tend to be a bit muddy if swiped too often. But yeah, you will see when you try it yourself if it needs some tweaking or if it's okay on the first one. So when the swipe was done and everything looked in a way as I wanted it to look, I had to separate all of these tiny canvases to make them dry individually, because if you would have dried it on the grill, everything would have stick together and you would have created one really big canvas thingy, which would not have worked in the very end. And to separate them, I prepped an MDF board with some kitchen clear film. So I just wrapped it around, put it aside, and used a smaller palette knife and separated all these tiny canvases and put it onto the clear film. And the clear film, because nothing really sticks to it once it's dried, so you can put your canvases on there, and even if there is some paint running underneath the canvas, you can put it on there and just be fine when it's dried. If you put it onto a more stickier surface, like paper or such, it will stick to the paper once dried and you will have a mess again and much work to do to remove the paper. So clear film is a good thing to do. Or if you have a silicone mat, will do the same, just a surface where nothing can really stick to. And depending how thick your pour actually was, you might be ending up having some of the paint still running down from the canvases. So after a while, I think an hour or so, I just pulled up all these small canvases again and moved it to a cleaner surface, just to have them clean, and the paint already started to settle a bit, and so it was easier for me to have clean edges in the end when it's dry, other than having all the paint residue hanging around on the side of the canvases once dried. But this is again up to you if you want to do this, and if you have paint running from the canvases once separated, of course. Most of them were dry until the next day, so it was quite quickly, and you want them to be fairly dry so that nothing can smudge when you go over it. And once they were dry, I just flipped them over and painted the bottom side of the canvases with white gesso. This step is more or less optional, I'd say. So there is no actually need to overpaint it, but I think it looks a bit more, well, in a way professional if the bottom side of the canvases is more clean. Because as it's a quite messy process and I was putting them on the clear film, there was colored right underneath and it was a bit messy looking, which in a way is no big deal because once done, these magnets are hanging on the fridge anyways. But you know, perfectionism is a really tough thing at times, and so I wanted to have them a bit cleaner on the bottom side. So I used a white gesso, you can use also acrylic paint, whatever you have available, it can be any color of course, but I just picked the white gesso because I thought this might be the most opaque color I have. And once this was dried, I needed to add the magnets. And these tiny magnets I've also ordered on Amazon, which was my recommended product there. They come in sets of 50 and about 9 euros or so, so quite affordable. And they are really, really strong. So one of these tiny magnets will be enough for one canvas. And they are strong enough to hold a couple of papers on your fridge or any magnetic surface, actually. So once you have your canvases painted or not painted and have your magnets ready, then comes the question, how can you make these things stick on your canvases? And I personally have used resin so far. As I will use resin for the very last part anyways, I used resin for this part as well. And so I mixed my resin, and you can use whatever resin you have. You might also use some super glue if you do not want to use resin, or whatever you have available. Just something that is really sticky and can combine the magnet, which is an even and metal surface, with the paper texture surface that the canvas has. So, but super glue might work as well. I'm not sure, I've not tested it. So for me the resin worked really well. And the resin that I've used for this one took about 3 to 4 hours until it is dried and you can continue with the next part. So adding the resin, just a little drop on each of the canvas, and then I push the magnet onto it. And you need to push the magnet down a bit because otherwise it would be floating around on the resin and move to what any position it wants to. So add the resin, put the magnet in, and then push onto the magnet just to make it stick to the canvas. And then everything was quite fine. So for this project I threaded until the next day, until everything was really completely dry. And I continued with the final part that I had to do, which was putting a layer of resin over the front side. And basically you do not need to use resin, you can leave them blank as you like, so no cover at all. You can also use an acrylic varnish if you like, or you can use the resin. The resin and the varnish just have the positive effect that they seal the surface and that colors come out more vibrant. But again, as it's just more or less some fridge magnets, you don't need to care so much about it. But, well, I wanted to go for the resin, and I mixed up my resin and I put a drop of silicone into the resin. And this is because we still have some silicone onto the canvases, which I have mixed into the color in the very first place. I could have spent 1 or 2 hours to really clean all these canvases to remove the silicone, but yeah, this, no, really not. And so I decided to just mix a drop of silicone into my resin, which in a way compensates the resin onto the artwork. It works perfectly. So just in case you do not know, if you have silicone residue on your artwork and you go over it with the resin straight away, you might end up having some gaps in the resin. So whenever there is a tiny bit of silicone onto your canvas and you put resin over it, the resin will disappear from this area and so you will have gaps or holes in the end when it's dry. If you add a tiny little bit of silicone into the resin and stir it very good, you can add the silicone over your canvases and you will not end up having some gaps. But keep in mind, when you add the silicone into the resin and stir it, the resin itself will become a bit milky. So if you go for really thick pours of resin on some artwork, it will change the colors as the resin will be a bit milky. As we only go for a very tiny thin layer of resin, it doesn't change anything. I just mixed up my resin, used some gloves because resin is always a sticky thing, pushed my fingers into the resin and made a layer of the resin over each and every canvas, which takes a bit of time of course, and you have about 30 minutes ish something time, depends on the resin, to complete your task. If you are not fast enough and you realize that the resin is going to heat up and get sticky, you can decide if you continue as long as it works in a way or just mix some new resin. And then I just put it again onto some clear film, just to not have the resin stick onto the surface. And again, once this is dried, nothing will stick to the clear film and you can remove them quite easily. And basically, this is it. It was a really fun process to make. They look really pretty, and the ones that look not so pretty you can just sort out and pour something over it in the next go. I now have a fridge full of magnets, which I will put on Etsy in the next weeks. I will do some more just to have a couple available if people are crazy about them and want to order quite many of them, which I hope and would feel honored, to be honest. So, if you try this for your own, just let me know and show me the results. I'm really happy to see what other of my followers create, and please share it with me on Facebook or Instagram. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and this is the first video that I've seen, I would be honored if you subscribe to my channel. It will really mean a lot to me. And if you want to get notified, you can click the bell icon. Otherwise, I hope to see you in my next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.